Hello and welcome to Established Africa Insight. Today we have three esteemed guests with us in studio, the chairman of Heavenly Culture, World Peace and Restoration of Light, HWPL, Mr. Manhi Lee, the director of International Peace Youth Group, Mr. Chong Yong Min, and the chairwoman of International Women's Peace Group, Ms. Yoon Hyun Suk, as well as the peace delegation. Our guests landed on South African soil on Thursday, having traveled all the way from South Korea to deliver an important message of peace. Today, Mr. Lee is here to talk to us about his vision for Africa, as well as how the HWPL plays a role in this. Let's take a short moment to watch a highlight video in this regard. Let's watch the video.
Together in the noble cause of peace. We address the sources of conflict and present a solution for peace. We are creating a bright future for humanity, opening an era of global harmony. In the Republic of Korea, a peace movement began by people determined to achieve a war-free world. Bringing together peace-loving people around the world, HWPL, a non-governmental peace organization, is increasingly recognized by the international community.
World Peace and Restoration of Light has begun with this, our Declaration of World Peace.
Starting from the Declaration of World Peace that proclaimed an era of peace today, our peace movement has brought changes to different parts of the world. In Mindanao, Philippines, a region scarred by its 40-year conflict, HWPL peace agreement was signed between local representatives of the Catholic Church and Islam. After signing the agreement, fruits of peace are appearing throughout Mindanao. These results were possible because everyone participated in our peace movement with one same heart. Leaders in different sectors of society are working as our advisory council and publicity ambassadors around the world. The world is quickly becoming one with us, proving that peace is the common wish of humanity. The world is discussing, practicing, and witnessing peace. In September every year, people from around the world come to Korea. The WARP Summit is widely known as a global peace festival, an international conference that brings about practical results. For a non-governmental peace organization, it is a remarkable achievement that it gathered people from all walks of life and countries in one place on its own. The participants say the WARP Summit is a unique occasion where love for humanity and spirit of peace are embodied. The way we organize and coordinate the event systematically is highly rated, even when compared to other international conferences. Anyone who comes to this festival can thoroughly experience the heavenly culture, which is a source of peace. Especially the card section performance by 12,000 IPYG members move the audience of different languages, races, and cultures, instilling peace in their hearts. The WARP Summit is evolving into a global peace festival, so much so that it is giving the divided Korean Peninsula a new name, the Nation of Peace. On September 18th, 2014, two historical pledges were made while the world looked on, and these pledges have developed into our main peace campaigns. To bring more tangible results, HWPL's Family of Peace had intensive discussions during the second annual commemoration of the Warp Summit. Leaders from various fields realized their mission and made a determination to fulfill it in this generation. The noble cause of eliminating wars and sustaining peace for future generations is now a concrete goal before our eyes. The Warp Summit is held based on a definite solution for achieving peace and establishes a new benchmark for peace. We are creating a new order for the world. To fundamentally resolve international conflicts and crises, we have been advancing our work in a more concrete and professional direction. The HWPL International Law Peace Committee was established to discuss how to achieve peace through international law. It is comprised of legal experts of different nationalities. After three official committee meetings, the Declaration of Peace and Cessation of War was finalized. On March 14, 2016, the declaration consisting of 10 articles and 38 clauses was proclaimed in the Republic of Korea. Currently, advocacy activities are underway worldwide to achieve adoption of the declaration by the United Nations. The new law of peace that the world is making together will change the history of humanity. Religion is returning to its original role in restoring peace. HWPL, World Alliance of Religions Peace Office, was established to resolve conflicts and misunderstanding among religious groups. Chairman Lee's clear guidelines for religion are leading people of religion today in the right path.
If religions are in harmony with each other, there will be no reason to fight. To achieve harmony among religions, people of religion should examine and compare their scriptures to find the truth and become one in that truth. People of religion are responsible for leading people of the world in the right path.
Here at the HWPL Warp offices, leaders of various religious groups are gathering, having discussions about religion and scriptures. These meetings are taking place in major cities around the world. The purpose of such comparative study of religious texts is to bring religion back to its original role and become one under the will of the Creator. HWPL Warp offices are fostering understanding and harmony among many religions of the world, moving in the direction for the sake of humanity. We are building peace that will last for future generations. Now, we need education for peace. The right education can change our future. Our children should learn precious values so that they can create a happy future with their own hands and protect it.
We must educate all humanity to install in them love and peace so that our youth will no longer be sacrificed in war. For this purpose, we have been resolved to participate in the peace work of HWPL as an HWPL Peace Academy and to become messenger of peace to educate about the peace movement.
The number of HWPL Peace Academies is increasing around the world, and they are teaching about our peace movement and spirit. Through such education, our children will grow into leaders who will protect peace. The world recognizes and remembers our achievements. All the awards and plaques commemorate HWPL's contributions to humanity. The true peace award that we want is peace being actually achieved on the earth. HWPL days are holidays of peace that all people celebrate. HWPL days are being declared around the world January 24th as the Mindanao Peace Agreement Day, May 25th as the Declaration of World Peace Day, and September 18th as the World Alliance of Religions Day. To commemorate the day on which promises were made for peace and cessation of war, the monument to the success of the Warp Summit was erected. Many are volunteering to join in to erect the monument in their respective countries and testify to the evidence of peace. The world is becoming one family beyond all borders of nationality, race, and religion. Towards a new era of peace, we are walking hand in hand. We are HWPL.
Welcome back. Now that you're more familiar with the work of HWPL, it's time to get to know the man behind the organization. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon.
네, 오늘 이 자리에 함께해 주셔서 감사합니다.
네, 감사합니다.
Thank you for inviting us.
Chairman Lee, you have been around the world spreading the message of peace for a very long time now. And including this trip, this would be the 29th peace trip. Would you please tell us more about the work of HWPL and the work of peace that you do?
세계를 29회 다니시면서 평화 일을 하셨다고 들었습니다. 하시는 평화의 일에 대해서 더 자세하게 소개해 주셨으면 좋겠습니다.
예, 말씀드리겠습니다.
Yes, yes, I'll tell you about the work.
아프리카 국민 여러분들 안녕하십니까?
Greetings to the citizens of Africa.
대한민국 소원 HWPL 평화의 사자들입니다.
We are the delegates, peace delegates from South Korea.
금번 아프리카에 온 것은 저희들이 일하고 있는 평화 일에 대해서 또 국제법 제정한 것에 대해서 필요 이것이 꼭 필요하다는 필요성을 말씀드리기 위해서 왔습니다.
The purpose of our trip this time is to promote our work of peace and to promote the necessity of the DPCW 10 Article 38 clauses that we are working on right now.
저는 평화의 일을 하기 위해서 국경도, 인종도, 종교도 다 초월했습니다.
In order for me to work for the peace, I've transcended borders, races, and religion.
그리고 평화를 이뤄서 있는 답을 가지고 지구촌을 돌고 돌았습니다.
And I've traveled around the world with the answer to achieve peace.
정치인들, 사회인들, 종교인들을 만나가지고 평화를 이루고 함께 이루게 자고 약속을 했습니다.
I met the politicians, people from various societies, and religious people, and we asked them to work together to achieve peace.
그리고 대한민국에서 망국회의를 열었습니다.
And we have we had an activity event in Korea called World Alliance Religious Peace.
정치인들은 국제법을 제정할 것을 종교인들은 종교가 하나님 안에서 하나 될 것을 천지를 불러 증거로 삼고 약속을 했습니다.
So at that time, we asked the politicians to support the DPCW 10 Article 38 clauses. And we asked the religious leaders to unite under one creator. And heavens, before heavens and the earth, they made promise together.
이 약속은 하나님 앞에서 세계 만민 앞에서 이룰 것을 약속했습니다.
They made the promise that they'll fulfill their promise before God and the people of the earth.
그러거나 국제법 제정하는 일에 대해서 DPCW 10조 38항을 만들어 온 세계에 알렸습니다.
And we have drafted DPCW 10 Article 38 clauses and we'll spread the news of our activity.
그리고 우리 사자들이 이 아프리카에 온 것은 DPCW 10조 38항이 폐화를 이룰 수 있고 전쟁을 종결할 수 있는 필요성에 대한 것을 알리기 위해서 왔습니다.
And the purpose of the delegates here visiting Africa is to tell people that the DPCW 10 Article 38 clauses may be the answer to achieve peace.
지가 만난 지구촌의 모든 사람들은 단 한 사람도 전쟁을 원하는 사람은 없었습니다.
Everyone that I've met, no one wanted to have war.
다 평화를 원했습니다.
Everybody wanted peace.
DPCW 10조 38항 이대로 하면 틀림없이 전쟁이 종식되고 평화가 이루어집니다.
So if we can follow the guideline provided by DPCW, then we can seize the war.
이것이 평화를 이룰 수 있는 답입니다.
This may be the resolution to achieve peace.
지금은 많은 사람들이 이 지구촌에서 평화 일을 하고 있습니다.
There are many people in the world doing peace activities.
아프리카 국민 여러분들, 아프리카 대통령 분들, 주의 말씀을 부탁을 드리고 싶습니다.
So I'm asking to the people of Africa and the president of Africa.
대통령께서는 나라와 국민을 사랑하고 있는 줄 압니다.
I'm sure the head of states of African nations love their citizens.
나라와 국민이 원하는 전쟁 정치 평화를 대통령께서 마다하지 아니할 줄로 압니다.
And I truly hope that the president will not say no to the peace and cessation of the war that the citizens want to have.
나라와 국민이 원하는 DPCW 10조 38항 여기에다가 대통령께서 꼭 사인해 주셔야 합니다.
So the president, I'm asking president to support the DPCW 10 Articles 38 clauses.
국제법 개정한 이 DPCW 이것은 현재 유엔에 가 있습니다.
The drafted DPCW is currently has been arrived at UN.
유엔 총회에 상정되겠고 상정되면은 유엔 총회에서는 투표에 붙일 것입니다.
And this DPCW will be proposed to the higher council and it will be put on a vote.
전쟁 종식을 위해서 평화를 위해서 모든 각국 대통령께서는 이 DPCW 여기에다가 사인해 주시길 부탁드립니다.
So I'm asking the president to support DPCW which could seize the war.
대통령님께 다시 한 번 말씀드립니다. 국민 없는 나라가 없고 나라가 있기에 대통령이 있는 것입니다. 대통령께서는 국민이 원하는 이 전쟁 정지 평화 여기에다 꼭 사인해 주시길 부탁의 말씀드립니다.
So I'm asking to the president once again that there will be no nation if there's no people. And there will be no president if there are no people. So I'm asking president to support the DPCW.
또 한 가지 더 있다면 아프리카 모든 국민께서도 평화의 사자가 되어서 함께 평화 일을 이루어 갔으면 좋겠습니다.
And I'm asking to the people of Africa that they may become the messengers of peace and work to achieve peace together.
전쟁 정세 평화는 누구의 개인 것이 아닙니다.
Cessation of war and the peace does not belong to one person. It's for everybody. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Chairman Lee. Director, this next question is for you. Article 10 of the DPCW speaks about the importance of education in promoting a culture of peace. May you please tell us more about the activities that the organization is doing around the world in regards to peace education?
네, 평화 세계적으로 일어나고 있는 평화 교육에 대해서 설명 부탁드립니다.
네, 평화 교육에 대해서 답변 드리도록 하겠습니다.
So I'll introduce the work that we are doing on the peace education.
이 대표님께서 DPCW의 장점에 대해서 강조를 해 주셨는데요.
Chairman Lee emphasized the pros about the DPCW.
DPCW의 10조에 보면 평화 문화의 전파와 그리고 평화 교육의 중요성에 대해서 어필하고 있습니다.
If you read the 10th article of DPCW, it emphasizes the spreading the culture of peace and educating for peace as well.
왜냐하면 평화의 법이 필요하지만 그 법이 세워지고 그 다음에는 후대들이 그 법을 계속 지킬 수 있도록 교육시키는 것이 중요하기 때문입니다.
The reason is that yes, we need the law for peace. So the law must be established, but then the future generations must be educated so that they may continue on abiding the law.
그래서 저희 그 평화 교육에서는 전 세계적으로 현재 10개국 142개의 학교에서 함께 평화 교육을 진행해 나가고 있습니다.
So currently in 10 countries and 142 schools, peace education is currently happening.
그리고 평화 교육은 초등학교, 그리고 중학교, 고등학교, 대학교 모든 학교들과 함께 하고 있습니다.
And the peace education is happening starting from the primary school all the way up to university level.
네. 그래서 지금 평화 교육에 대한 교재도 전 세계적으로 배포가 되고 있고 많은 학생들이 이 평화 교육 교재를 갖고 평화의 시민으로 자라나고 있습니다.
So the peace material has been distributed around the world and the students are being educated with this material and they're becoming the citizens of peace.
네, 감사합니다.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Chairwoman, this question is for you. The International Women's Peace Group, it focuses on women all over the world and how they should protect their children. What role should South African women play in the work of peace?
여성 대표님께 질문 드리겠습니다. 세계적으로 여성들이 평화의 일에 참여해야 된다고 많은 말씀을 해주셨는데 남아공에 있는 여성들이 어떻게 평화를 위해서 일할 수 있는지 한 말씀 부탁드립니다.
네, 먼저 저는 대한민국에서 온 IWPG 대표 윤현숙입니다.
Firstly, I am Yun Hyun-suk, coming from Korea. I'm the representative of International Women Peace Group.
우리 IWPG는 HWPL의 날개로서 전 세계 37억의 여성들과 하나가 되어 전란에서 자녀를 지키고 후대의 평화의 세계를 유산으로 물려주기 위해 일하고 있습니다.
IWPG is one of the wings of HWPL, and we are working with the 3.7 billion women in the world. And we are working to protect our children from war and to build peaceful nations and leave it as a legacy to our future generation.
우리 IWPG는 평화 문화 전파를 위한 모든 활동과 또 평화 교육 그리고 HWPL의 DPCW 재정에 대한 촉구의 활동을 하고 있습니다.
So we are working to spread the culture of peace and to provide education of peace. And also we are working to urge people to support DPCW.
아프리카에서는 1950년에 한국 전쟁이 있을 당시 우리나라를 이제 많이 도와주셨습니다. 우리나라가 이렇게 발전할 수 있었던 배경에는 아프리카 국민들의 희생과 피가 있었기 때문입니다.
In 1950s, when Korea had war, nations from Africa came to help our nation. And from there on, we were able to develop and improve well. And our development comes from sacrifices and the blood of the African people.
우리 대한민국 국민과 또 IWPG는 이런 아프리카 국민들의 피와 희생에 대해서 감사하고 있습니다.
And we are truly grateful, IWPG and people of South Korea are truly grateful for the sacrifices made by the African people.
우리 대한민국이 또 급속도로 발전할 수 있었던 이유 중에 하나는 우리 어머니들의 뜨거운 교육열이 있었기 때문입니다.
Another factor for rapid advancement of our nation was the passion of the mothers to provide education to our children.
우리 여성과 어머니들의 그 뜨거운 교육열은 자녀 교육에서 더 나아가서 국민들의 교육으로 이어졌습니다. 아프리카 여성 여러분들께서도 이러한 교육에 힘을 써 주신다고 하면 이 아프리카의 국가의 발전과 또 경제 발전을 이룩할 수 있는 큰 힘이 될 수 있을 것 같습니다.
So the such passion from mothers was not just education, but it provide education for our children to grow as abiding citizens. So if the mothers, African mothers, also have passion for education and provide education to the children, then such rapid improvement of the nations will happen.
남아프리카 공화국의 여성 여러분들뿐만이 아니라 아프리카에 있는 모든 영부인들께도 또 부탁의 말씀을 드리겠습니다.
And not just to the mothers of South Africa, but I would like to deliver message to the first ladies of the nations of Africa.
영부인은 국모이자 또 그 나라의 국민들의 어머니이시고 더 나아가서는 온 인류의 어머니입니다.
First ladies are the mother of the nation, but moreover, they're mother of their citizens, and mother of all world.
남아프리카 공화국의 여성 여러분들과 또 아프리카 대륙에 있는 모든 여성 여러분들은 우리 IWPG와 하나가 되어 주셔서 평화의 메시지를 전해 주시고 또 평화 교육과 평화 문화 전파에 힘을 써 주신다고 하면 이 인류 세계의 평화 전쟁 종식을 위한 세계 평화를 이룰 수 있는 큰 힘이 될 것 같습니다.
So if the mothers of South Africa and all the continents of Africa could gather their hearts with IWPG and unite their hearts together, then we can work together for the peace and the cessation of the war and by providing peace education and peace materials to our children and child.
또한 우리 이 대표님께서 제시하고 계시는 DPCW 안에는 우리가 겪고 있는 모든 문제를 해결할 수 있는 답이 있습니다.
And the DPCW that the Chairman Lee has emphasized, if you read it, it has the answer to achieve peace.
우리가 지금 시대에 살고 있는 모든 인류에게는 이 시대에 전쟁을 종식하고 세계 평화를 이루어야 하는 그런 사명을 가지고 태어났다고 생각을 합니다.
I think we who are born in this generation have duty to bring all the wars to the end.
그래서 우리 아프리카에 계신 모든 여성 여러분들은 우리 IWPG와 하나가 되어 주시고 또 예전에는 그 몇몇 아프리카의 몇몇 나라들이 우리나라를 도와주셨지만 이제는 아프리카 대륙의 모든 나라가 하나가 되어 주셔서 우리 평화의 일에 하나가 되어 주신다고 하면 이 시대에 가장 복을 받고 또 발전할 수 있는 국민들이 될 것이라고 확신합니다. 감사합니다.
So I'm asking the mothers to mothers of South, not just South Africa, but all Africa, to gather their hearts with IWPG and work with them. And in that way, we could bring peace to the world, and we can bring the cessation of the war. As in 1950s, few nations of South Africa of the Africa helped South Korea, but if all the African continents, nations of Africa, could help with the work that we do, then the nation, the peaceful nation that we hope for, will be truly achieved by our generation. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Chairman Lee, what words or hope would you like to share with Africa at this time?
아프리카 사람들에게 소망되는 말씀 하나만 전달해달라고 하십니다.
네. 지구촌 가족 여러분들, 또 각국 대통령님들, 우리 DPCW는 지구촌의 전쟁이 종식되게 하고 평화를 이루어 영원한 후대의 유산이 될 것입니다. 꼭 이 10조 38항이 유엔에서 상정될 때에 각국 대통령께서는 사인해 주셔야 합니다. 이를 사인하지 아니하면은 평화 보담도 전쟁을 원하는 대통령님이라고 지목이 될 것입니다. 그렇지 않겠습니까? 하니 대통령께서는 분명히 전쟁이 동시되고 평화 이루어질 수 있는 10조 38항에 꼭 사인해 주시기 바랍니다. 그리고 지구촌 모든 가족님들 우리 다 평화의 사자가 되어 하루속히 평화를 이루도록 합시다. 부탁드립니다. 대단히 감사합니다.
So to the people of the world and to all the presidents of the world, as the DPCW is being introduced to UN, please support the DPCW. If you sign and agree with DPCW, then we can achieve the world of peace together. But for any reason, if the president decides to refuse to support, then that could mean that they do not want peace. So please gather your hearts and please support DPCW. And to the people of the world, let us become the messengers of peace so that we may gather our hearts together and so that we may achieve the world of peace together. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much for being with us today. And thank you to the peace delegation.
네, 오늘 함께해 주셔서 너무 감사합니다.
예, 수고했습니다.
네, 그리고 뒤에 계신 평화의 사자분들도 너무나도 감사합니다.
Thank you so much for joining us today and for being with us in this amazing interview that we had. And we'll see you again next time. Enjoy your day.